Actually, we also apply for the Bounty 12. We'll show a feature of easy NFT creation in an implementation later in our videos. And first, let me introduce our project. What is S Protocol? We are building a Web3 enablers for Web2 platforms. Every day, you guys are using their Twitter, Meta, Facebook, Instagram. They are all centralized platforms, but actually they don't have the features of Web3. So once in the very beginning of the product design, Michael and I will want to engage more Web2 users to use these Web3 features in their everyday life to enable their such as some features of social and commerce, Web3 social features and Web3 commerce features on Web2 platforms. Yeah, here's our mission values. We will create a open, free, fair, very social multiverse ecosystem for everyone, for every Web2 users. And we will also provide a massive adoption for their tokenization of everything in everyone's daily life. We assume that, we estimate that there could be over 2 billion users which migrated by our S protocols. Currently, there is only about maybe less than 3 million users by the data surveyed of MetaMask, in March, in 2022. But we foresee there could be a very huge, tremendous increase in their users of Web3 site. So, what can we do for these users? Since, as you know, the Web3 application is quite difficult to use for those Web2 users. So, our teams think over how to engage these users to the Web3 areas. We summarize some very obvious problems here. And actually, currently, we are still lack of personal identity, especially to aggregating the social network accounts with a Web3 wallet address. So when you want to tip your friends on Facebook or Twitter, so you have to ask him to give you the address. It's very confusing for the newcomers, right? So another thing is, there's still a lot of data on the Web2 platform. So once the Web3 application want to interact with these Web2 users, so it's very hard for them to reach this data. And another thing, for the commerce side, since I have been engaged in the game sectors and as an investors, so I met a lot of creators. Some guys are doing the illustration for animation, and other guys are doing their very cool music. But they often ask me, Irvin, how to mint an NFT and how to transfer an NFT to my friends. So they have no knowledge, they have no idea about how to do this. So there are very high barriers for them to, for these creators to build stores of NFTs and to do some promotion on Web2 side, I suppose. So the last thing is we often talk about accessibility of Web3. So most people have not even owned fungible tokens or for non-fungible tokens for in their lifetime, right? So we have to solve these problems. If we don't have the capability to solve this problem, no one could use the dApp something like DeFi or even to hold an NFT. Here is what we want to do in future. Actually, we are building a first social network aggregator protocol layers. And based on the protocol layers, we will also provide a decentralized commerce infrastructure. We call it a Web3 Shopify. Yeah. Let's go to the video section. Yeah, I will show how the Astro protocol changed the world of Web2 and to migrating the Web2 users to Web3.
Today, we will be exploring the key features on our current prototype, which will show you how we upgrade Web2 social platforms to Web3. So we can actually connect every user on any social network to a Web3 address without using an API. So today, we're going to be taking Elon Musk's Twitter account as an example. We're going to start by clicking the star icon in the browser extension tab, where we find the wallet addresses of all the chains already connected. We're going to connect the BNB address to the Twitter account for a signed signature of the message, all that is needed. We're then going to post this, and our decentralized backend servers will verify the information and map that post with a smart contract for future use. So now we're going to click the star icon again, where we'll find the Binance address has been connected to our Twitter account. So in this second section, we have our NFT collection stored on our account. So if we click the icon, we can see our collection, none for sale, none in the showcase. But we want to display these. So we go to our portal. We select the NFTs that we want displayed. We click save, sign again. And then when we click, we can actually see in the showcase our collection.
Okay, actually we have completed deployment on our testnet of BNB chain. And once we have finished the deployment on mainnet of BNB chains, more users could take back their control of their social data and monetize the traffic of their in the Web3 website. So I will want to clarify one thing here. Since actually we're connect social accounts with Web3 wallet address with our Twitter accounts. So our mates just have a small misstatement about to say to connect the Twitter account of Elon Musk with his wallet address. It's not this things. We are doing the connection between our Twitter account with our Web3 wallet address. And let's go further to see how we can realize the easy adoption of tokenization of Twitter. Okay.
In this next stage, we're going to look at our collection and we're going to see that we have no NFTs for sale. So we're going to change this. So we're going to scroll down and hover over the star icon under the social post. There's three options: send tokens and NFTs, and then we can actually tokenize the post too. So this will allow users to send crypto or NFTs to each other. So if we click tokenize, gives you a preview. We're going to say okay, wait for confirmation. We're going to confirm this. And we can actually see the transaction has been executed using the BSC scan. Right. Now we can actually go through and list the NFT we have just created. So if we go list, choose our list price, 1 BNB, we're going to go OK. We're going to press confirm. And now when we go back, press the star icon again, and we can see that that minted post is in our collection. There it is. And listed for sale. So this feature also allows us to sell other NFTs that are stored in collected wallets and show these NFTs across multiple social accounts. And we facilitate marketing and promotion on social platforms with this tool. We also have feed on ramps built in. I want to leave you all with this. At the moment, Web2 platforms are highly centralized. This data that should be owned and controlled by the users themselves isn't. So we want to change this and make the new era of self-sovereignty a reality. The symbol of that stands for the closed Web2 systems. Let's change this and make Web3 easily accessible to everyone, everywhere. Thank you.
Cool. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I have something in the DAX have to introduce ourselves, the DAX to our judges. So Aster, actually we are a first social identity aggregators. So you can think what is 1inch? 1inch is aggregating order DAX and including the Uniswap. And we Aster Nimsers will do the connection between the Web2 accounts and the Web3 ID and a blockchain address, including a layer one and layer two. And here is a very innovative account system. We call it a synthetic Web3 account. We doing the mapping for Web2 accounts and deployed them under smart contracts on each public chains. Yeah, so with that mechanism, we can approach 5 billion users of the Web2 social networkers. Yeah. Okay. So another thing for what is Aster is doing is we will lower the barriers for creators to enter the Web3 commerce. So here, you can see the data here. GMV of NFT in 2021 was only 23 billion, but based on the ARK's research, the annual online expenditure was 1.4 trillion according to their research. And the data, the figure will increase to 12.5 trillion by 2013. So Aster Protocol is, we are building the tools for creators economies to aiming the 10 trillion market. Yeah. Okay, here the path for tokenization of a social post or social assets. We just do the demonstration. Yeah, I will skip this one. Yeah. So finally, I will introduce some use cases where we have finished, and we are something we are still in the progress. First, our partner, who is a very famous animators in Japan, which name is Wilson. He founded the Skyfall, and he also had a very good connection with the big title holders such as Gundam, City Hunter, and something like that. So he needed us to build a NFT stores for him, just with a few clicks, and to use the Aster protocol to approach more fans on Web2 side. And another thing is about an EDM, a club metaverse, which is produced by Discovery, another Japanese company. They published EDM NFT with very big names, but they are lack of some tools to approach these DJs fans. So we provide our Aster protocol, this solution for them. And developers in Japan, which name is Mitsui Fudosan, they will hold a online and offline online gallery of NFT arts for their 80 years anniversary. So they will use our tools to a show to showcase their NFTs on their Twitter site.